It's time to choose sides. Is butter the main villain or the secret underdog? Hint, it's not as harmful as people think. From recent studies to fiction stories and historical myths, here is everything you need to know about the link between butter and heart disease, and why this one ingredient became so hated for no reason. But before we jump in, please note that everything mentioned in this video is unbiased, fact-checked, and reviewed by qualified health professionals. What is butter? To most, butter is a delicious ingredient that can elevate any dinners. But for some, butter is a collection of saturated, monounsaturated, and polyunsaturated fat molecules that create the overall structure of this dairy product. Fun fact, the history of butter actually goes back as far as 4,000 years, where there is evidence of ancient civilizations making butter with special homemade devices. But back in the day, butter wasn't seen as a dangerous ingredient, but more as a luxury that could only be obtained by the lucky few. Coming back to the modern age, butter has transformed the culinary scene with its diversity, rich flavor, and texture, and its application in both traditional and innovative cuisines. Having said that, we can't help but shine a light on the negative aspects of butter. The historical journey of butter, from hero to villain and back again. For centuries, butter has been a cherished staple in our diets, celebrated for its rich flavor and culinary versatility. Before the emergence of intricate scientific research and meta-analyses, butter was hailed as the hero ingredient in numerous dietary guides. As early as 1917, health and dietary publications proclaimed the benefits of incorporating butter into daily meals, emphasizing its role in ensuring child health and proper development. By 1958, butter's reputation soared even higher, being recognized as one of the four daily foods essential for adults to maintain body weight at a level most favorable to health and well-being. However, the mid-20th century brought about a seismic shift in butter's standing. The post-World War II era saw a concerning rise in heart disease rates, prompting scientists to scrutinize our dietary habits more closely. In the 1950s and 60s, groundbreaking studies began to surface, linking saturated fats, like those found in butter, to heart disease. Dr. Ansel Keys, a leading nutritionist of the time, spearheaded the influential seven-country study, which suggested a potent correlation between dietary fat intake and heart disease. This pivotal research played a significant role in shaping dietary guidelines across the globe. Reacting to these findings, the food industry swiftly introduced low-fat and fat-free products, championing margarine made with hydrogenated oils as a healthier alternative to butter. Advertisements and health advisories further entrenched the belief that butter was detrimental to one's health. This negative perception was further exacerbated in 1977, when the Senate Select Committee on Nutrition released warnings against foods that provide calories but few nutrients. They highlighted links to chronic illnesses and increased body weights, and unsurprisingly, butter was spotlighted as a primary offender. Following this damning dietary guide, butter faced an uphill battle to restore its tarnished reputation among global citizens. Yet, as time progressed, more comprehensive research emerged, revealing a multifaceted relationship between saturated fats, heart health, and overall well-being. It became evident that the demonization of butter was, in part, grounded in incomplete or misinterpreted data. Even more alarming was the revelation that some alternatives, especially margarines laden with trans fats, posed even greater health risks. Today, as our understanding of nutrition continues to evolve, butter is experiencing a renaissance. We now approach the topic with a more balanced perspective, recognizing the intricate nuances of fats and their effects on our health. The journey of butter, from its revered status to vilification and its current path to redemption, serves as a testament to the ever-evolving nature of dietary science and public perception. The science of fats, understanding the physiology behind butter and beyond. When it comes to butter, Opinions are as varied as the dishes it graces. To truly understand the ongoing debate surrounding butter, we'd have to delve into the physiological mechanisms of how the fat molecules in butter interact with our bodies. At the heart of this discussion are saturated fats, which are notably abundant in butter. These fats play a significant role in raising levels of what's commonly termed as the bad cholesterol in our bloodstream, scientifically known as low-density lipoprotein, LDL. Elevated LDL levels can lead to cholesterol accumulation in our arteries. Over time, this buildup can cause blockages in blood vessels, setting the stage for health complications like atherosclerosis and coronary artery disease. However, it's crucial to recognize that saturated fats aren't just about cholesterol and heart attacks. They play a vital role in various physiological processes. For instance, saturated fats are essential for nutrient absorption, particularly for the absorption of fat-soluble vitamins like A, D, E, and K. Moreover, cholesterol, often vilified in popular discourse, is fundamental for cellular stability. Every cell in our body relies on cholesterol for its structural integrity. Beyond this, cholesterol is a precursor for the production of vital hormones, including estrogen, testosterone, and cortisol. These hormones regulate a myriad of functions in our bodies, from reproductive processes to stress responses. While saturated and polyunsaturated fats have been linked to certain health risks, monounsaturated fats emerge as the recommended alternative by many health professionals. These fats, intriguingly, have the ability to reduce cholesterol levels in the blood, subsequently lowering the risk of premature mortality. Foods like avocados, salmon, nuts, and seeds are the treasure troves of these monounsaturated, or as they're often termed, healthy fats. Unlike their saturated and polyunsaturated counterparts, these fats don't pose the same health risks. As we navigate the intricate landscape of dietary fats, it becomes evident that not all fats are created equal. The key lies in understanding their distinct physiological impacts and making informed dietary choices that align with our health goals. With a plethora of research available, such as the studies from NCBI and NIH, we're better equipped than ever to make decisions that serve our well-being. Butter versus margarine. Speaking of healthier alternatives, we can't forget to compare the popular butter substitute called margarine. Made with vegetable oil, margarine is unique in its composition, being cholesterol-free. However, along with having low amounts of saturated fats, margarine contains unhealthy trans fats that can cause low-grade inflammation in various tissues of the body. But that's not all. According to Harvard University, here is how we should approach the butter versus margarine debate. The truth is, there never was any good evidence that using margarine instead of butter cut the chances of having a heart attack or developing heart disease. Today, the butter versus margarine issue is really a false one. From the standpoint of heart disease, butter remains on the list of foods to use sparingly, mostly because it is high in saturated fat. Margarines, though, aren't so easy to classify. The older stick margarines turned out to be clearly worse for you than butter. Some of the newer margarines that are low in saturated fat, high in unsaturated fat, and free of trans fats are fine as long as you don't use too much. Butter versus health. Going back to our butter. University after university, study after study, many researchers have tried to find the definite correlations that could settle the debate once and for all. A systematic review and meta-analysis published in 2016 observed the connection between butter consumption and the risk of cardiovascular disease, diabetes, and total mortality. This study, filled with overwhelming data, analyzed over 600,000 individual participants that consumed an average of 14 grams of butter every day. Out of the 636,000 participants, only 28,000 deaths were reported, with 9,783 cases of cardiovascular disease and 24,000 cases of incident diabetes. Following detailed investigations, this meta-analysis concluded that the available evidence indicates small or neutral associations of butter consumption with all-cause mortality, cardiovascular disease, and type 2 diabetes. Doesn't sound too bad, right? Even Harvard University published a piece that seemed to side with butter. The article titled "Clarifying the Facts on Fat" shared this message. Unfortunately, amid all these nuanced research results, during the 1980s and 1990s, conventional wisdom and national guidelines in the US shifted the spotlight to reducing total fat. Period. Despite little or no evidence that this simplistic advice would prevent disease, their complicated message that some fats are good for you and others are bad didn't reach the general public. Science writer Barbara Moran continues to share some advice. Researchers say we should focus on healthy dietary patterns, rather than glorify or demonize specific nutrients. A healthy pattern includes heaps of fresh fruits and vegetables, whole grains, nuts, legumes, poultry, and fish. An unhealthy but all too frequent pattern, piles of processed meat, mounds of French fries, lots of white bread and potatoes, and processed breakfast cereals, giant sugary drinks, and packaged cupcakes for dessert. Butter in 2023. So, where do we stand now? Do we support the original prophecies of nutritious butter, or should we scour for healthier alternatives, such as monounsaturated fats or even margarine? While the jury is still out, it's becoming evident that the butter culture may be back in style. But before you dismiss butter entirely from your grocery list, keep in mind that individual approaches to a healthy diet and nutritional requirements vary greatly. After all, popcorn wouldn't taste the same without a touch of butter, don't you think? We certainly think so. Thanks everyone for watching. If you learned something new today, consider subscribing and comment down below what you want us to explore next.